Welcome to Redmen TV. After Liverpool drew their opening Europa League group stage clash,
1-1 draw with FC Sion. Liverpool drew 1-1 with Ruben Kazan. Not good enough.
Liverpool have just got their European campaign finally up and properly running.
The 2-1 win over Bournemouth. Could have had more goals.
As far as an entertaining game of football goes, you don't get much better than that.
A 0-0 draw with Augsburg.
Liverpool just beating Augsburg 1-0 in the Europa League.
As far as Liverpool go, are we good? Not really. Did we get the job done? Yes.
Liverpool smash Manchester United in the first leg of the Europa League.
We didn't concede an away goal. They're a shit side and we can go on and beat them next week at Old Trafford.
Liverpool have drawn with Manchester United 1-1 at Old Trafford.
Liverpool have just knocked Manchester United out of the Europa League.
Liverpool have drawn Dortmund.
Liverpool have just come away from Dortmund with a 1-0 draw.
As soon as I think we could have nicked that game. And
Liverpool Football Club, if there was any doubt in your mind, then we are European royalty. Look at that game tonight. The mighty red. 4-3.
I feel fucking pissed. I've not done anything.
Yes!
Liverpool have just lost 1-0 to Villarreal in the first leg of the semi-final of the Europa League. But the fact is, Brendan Rodgers never used to have those game plans in European nights. Jurgen Klopp, you can see that. You can see with better players, he'll do better.
Liverpool are going back to another European final.
That is the fucking best way to show justice for the fucking 96, I'm telling you.
So, I'm up. I'm awake. It's 4:30 in the morning. Chris is on his way around. The reason I know it's 4:30 in the morning is because the bunny told me so.
Yeah. Fucking going off, baby!
Who is it? Grandmaster Bates! Second person, who is it? It's Harry Tom! The final person, who is it? It's Aubrey, baby!
Hello, welcome to the Redmen TV. We are on a road trip to Basel. Liverpool versus Sevilla in the Europa League final in Switzerland. We're going from Liverpool and we're driving there.
Yeah, so we've hired a VW Shannon. It's a 7-seater car. Look at the beast, man. It is just incredible. We're setting off now. We're going to make our first stop at Sandbach for a Mackey's breakfast, of course. That's what it's about, isn't it? And then we've got to go all the way down to the Euro Tunnel at Folkestone. We've got to be there at 1:20, checking closes. There's no second guessing this. We've got to be there at 1:20. Straight over to Calais, and then it's Calais to Strasbourg, where our first night in the hotel will be.
Yeah, so there we go. Shall we embark?
Let's do it, Paul. Let's do it, man.
Right, Sam, because before we set off, shall we just make sure we sorted everything? We've got passports.
Yeah.
What else have we got?
Euros, even though we need Swiss francs.
Yeah, Euros, even though we need Swiss francs. What else? These.
So Chris has just picked me up. It's 5:00 in the morning. We're on the way to Basel, but there's a very important thing that's going to happen. Now, what the lads don't know, because we're going to pick Tom up, we're going to pick Aubrey up. They think we're taking them over to Basel on a road trip, which is true. What they don't know is that we've managed to procure tickets, not just for us two, but for them two as well.
Nice guys.
Which is nice guys.
Fuck is this thing, by the way? Go ahead. Motorcycle fucking funerals.
Okay, first stop. Sandbach services. The all-important fueling for the trip. It's a Mackey's brekkie. Chris has headed inside to pick up the brekkie, and then we're going to get back on the road to Basel.
Good. Tom, rate your Mackey's brekkie.
I love
Mackey's
hash brown.
Brother, hash brown. Spot on, lads.
Nico,
Jordan on that. I think I just closed my eyes and prayed that it was over. I think I just went.
Piece of advice for the swap. Very sensitive is the volume control. It is the fucking clit of musical.
No, you can find it for a start. It's pretty easy to find.
Here we go for 100 times, hanging the kids in every line, throw them up and let some shine, going out of my fucking mind, filthy mouth, no excuse, find a new place to hang this new place. You call me Superman, you hold in my hand.
Come on, Tom.
So, next stop, Bitchester?
Yeah.
Anyway, I bought the GB sticker for the car, for the tunnel, Lucas 8, and I'm taking over the drive. It's on.
Okay, so Paul's taking over the driving duties now. It falls to me to give the update. We're obviously on our way to the Euro Tunnel. We've just left Bitchester. We're making good time, to be perfectly honest with you. We'd be making better time, but Paul drives like an old woman. So, what are you going to do about that? Yeah, it's not a lie. We're in the outside lane. We probably shouldn't be. We should probably be in the left lane. But, you know, that is just what it is, isn't it, at the end of the day? No, seriously, we're making good time. Got a couple of hours now before we get down to the Euro Tunnel. If Paul gets us there in one piece, we'll be fine. If he doesn't, obviously, you'll never see this video. We're on the road to Basel now, but I think looking back at the competition on a whole, my favourite memory, look, we beat Manchester United in Europe, first time we ever clashed them in European competition, and we battered them. We obviously had an emotional game for Jurgen Klopp, the manager, against Borussia Dortmund in the quarterfinals, and then a really dominant performance at home against Villarreal to beat them. I think my favourite memory of that, though, and it could be my favourite footballing memory at the ground, and it is actually, is the Borussia Dortmund game. I mean, 3-1 down with 20 minutes to go, and then Coutinho, Sacco and Lovren step up to score 3 goals in 20 minutes, and just like the atmosphere then was just electric, and there was this almost an electricity in the air, this buzz around Liverpool, and it felt like something special was going to happen that night. I think as soon as the draw was made, we thought that something special could happen, and so often those type of things disappoint, and I think for me it went above and beyond, and I've never experienced anything quite like that where I felt so connected with so many people. So for me, this competition so far has connected me with Liverpool fans. I think it's connected Liverpool fans with the club and with the manager and with the players more than it has done, more than we've been connected with them in 20 years.
Right, okay, we've arrived at the Eurotunnel terminal. Chris, next stop, Belfast.
That's right, mate, we're going to Calais, aren't we? And then straight from Calais, 6.5 hour drive to Strasbourg, where we got a hole up for the evening.
Yeah, no, it's been pleasant, actually. I think the journey so far, I've actually quite enjoyed it. The sun seems to have disappeared for the moment, but now it's been out, the tunes have been banging.
Yes, they have, they're doing some banging tunes, mate.
And I'm excited, let's have a bit of stretch of the legs and then kick on for the next leg.
Walking down a ramp to a train station in Liverpool, but you're in a car this time. It's fucking weird.
I'm on a train!
We're driving on a train, and now you're gonna
believe us!
We're driving on a train!
I feel like I need to dive under that door and get a hat.
Slide!
Oh no, it's not. I've got pretty much shit on the Birkenhead Tunnel. Yeah?
Driving off a train.
Here we are, we've made it through the Euro Tunnel. We're on the other side. We are here in France in the glorious sunshine. You can see behind me, there's the train that I drove on and Chris drove off, because teamwork is high. in Team Redmen. We're here. Now begins leg two of the journey, the long and arduous trek to Strasbourg.
Random tunnel protests.
Chris is gobsmacked.
So, truckers protesting and fellas here looking clearly to get the toes run over. What's your toes? Your toes!
How are you dealing with this?
I'm fine.
People just leaving the doors open. It has now gone double laned on the old trucks. I feel like we're being led somewhere to be murdered.
Hey, what's being like from these sparrows? Falling or something? I felt like I was a sperm looking for an egg. It's fucking just been on for ages.
So here you go. Get on this. Matthew Valbuena. Mamadou Sakho on the coke. You just couldn't make it up. So, got a cup of tea from the vending machine. I got two tea bags. So I've got a spare tea bag if anyone wants a spare tea bag. What I didn't get with it was milk. So I've had to go and buy some milk separate. It's fine though. You know, I'll have the last laugh when I've got milk.
I don't know if you can tell in this light, but one's more red than the other.
It's already getting pink, I like it.
I was lucky.
Texting the fella up.
I am. I'm texting the man. A very, very sexy man.
Joe.
Yeah. In case you're wondering, that's Chris climbing up child slide.
Right. Okay. So we've stopped off. We're in front now. This is the second leg of the journey, and we need to navigate our way from the port of Calais, which is up here. So Strasbourg, which is here, which you were saying is going to be about six and a half hours. Okay, so got a number of ways we can do this, but we're going to follow the AA route planner that we printed off.
Excellent choice, bro.
Which is talking about taking us on the A26 E15. We've stopped off somewhere around here, I think.
Yeah,
it's good to know. And we've got to be careful not to get on the right on the wrong road, because if we stick on this road, the E15 takes us to Paris.
No, don't want to go to Paris.
And then the A4 E50, which takes us all the way here, past Metz, and then diverges down this way, the A4 E25, or the E50, either way, this is the general area we're going. I think we'll figure it out, and worst comes to worst, we've updated our data packs on our phones, so we'll just have to sat have it.
Nah,
be fine. Good, let's go.
Here we go, there's the map.
So far, so good with regards to the travel, I guess. I don't want to jinx it. We are very much halfway through day one, and we've now switched to the other side of the road on which you have to drive. Now, Chris is a pro when it comes to this. He's a dab hand. He's done this many times. I've never done this before. So, I mean, I guess it's fine on the motorway stretches, but there's going to be some city driving probably at some point, which is going to be fascinating. My nerves right now, I mean, we're still over 24 hours till the game kicks off. I'm doing okay. My nerves are centered more around making sure that we get where we need to be. It's like, because at the minute, this is just basically a really complicated holiday, you know, and you can never fully relax, I say, until you get your bag on your bed in the hotel or whatever. And obviously we haven't quite got that, because that again will only be at the end of day one. It's actually doing that and then once I set foot inside that stadium, I will probably be able to fully relax. And I think you could say that this season is, you could probably deem this season as a failure if Liverpool don't win the Europa League, because look at eighth place finish in the Premier League, not winning the League Cup, you know, losing two finals and finishing eighth. Well, you know what?
you know, Kenny Dalglish did something very similar, except he brought a piece of silverware home. Now, the difference is, of course, is that if you look at it purely analytically, that's an issue, but I don't. I view football with my heart, and for me, this season will be a first step towards something bigger, better and greater. There will be devastation if we don't lift the silverware at the end of the season, of course, because of, you know, just... I don't like seeing Liverpool lose games at the best of times, let alone cup finals, let alone European finals. But I don't think that, yeah, it's hard to judge. I think there will be a real tinge of disappointment around it, but an air of positivity going forward. I don't think we'll be devastated, flat on our arses, if everything doesn't go exactly to plan.
Slide it up.
Didn't want the right one.
Skills.
Yes.
Right-hand drive skills.
I didn't shut it correctly.
And how many kilometres have we driven with it open for?
I knew we were driving 130 kilometres an hour when I tried to shut it.
We could get some food at Pity Casino, but I feel it might be a bit of a gamble.
Today, isn't it, buddy? There you go. You started dreaming again. Cause the nighttime does your senses and the stars all look the same.
Hi. There's Paul.
Hi.
There's Aubrey.
Hello.
And there's Tom. Hey, we finally arrived in Strasbourg.
Hello, bonjour, bienvenue à Strasbourg. We've arrived.
I'll tell Christophe.
Il s'appelle. Christophe, oui. D'accord. Anyway, we're here at the end of day one of the Basel road trip. Chris, what's been the highlight of the day?
Honestly, I don't think I can say it on camera, but no, do you know what? We've had such a laugh in the car. Like, it's been incredible. Some of the conversation in the car has just been funny. I was dancing around to random tunes, has been wicked. And navigating through France has been cool too. Today's felt a bit like Liverpool beating Villarreal. We don't normally do it the easy way, but today we've done it the easy way. Everything's just gone to plan. Mm. So much so that we actually managed to get an earlier Channel Tunnel crossing, yep, which was a bit strange and not very Redmen TV, if I'm perfectly honest with you.
We're here almost 3 hours ahead of schedule as well, which
no,
is genuine.
No, it's not technically true, to be honest with you. We were due in at like 10:30, but I just wanted to keep you all honest. Just wanted to keep you all on pace, you know what I mean? And better than I exceed your expectations, then you're disappointed with me.
Makes a change. So yeah, we've got a massive day tomorrow. We're going to get up early, head over to Basel and start soaking up the atmosphere.
You're damn straight we are. We're going to be getting up at 5 a.m, Paul. Or we're going to still...
7 a.m, correct.
6 a.m, Paul. 7 a.m, Paul.
Excellent. Yeah, so yeah, all to look forward to, all to come. This has only been the first day. The real madness starts.
Effers out of a Kronenberg glass.
Cheers, boys.
Snapchat, apparently. Snapchat. Yeah.
Boys.
That was the fucking worst.
It's so tense.
Snapchat is shit. Shit idea.
Idiots from fucking Bambury. I've got me on the fucking raspberry schnapps. I've got something to say. I'm embarrassed about how much I eat falafel.
Look, it's alright. You'll find new lunches, you'll get through it. It'll be okay.
Falafel Anonymous, like the falafel anonymous.
But they've just left me alone. And I've been eating ridiculously late. And now we're drinking Efes in the park.
Badly, so there's Chris, and there's no trees anywhere to
hunt.
Night, Paul.
Night, Chris.
Love you.
Basically, going for some sort of art installation breakfast. I really feel that the layout
sort of symbolises the disparity in the feelings of the people present.
Chris was going for a shower, decided to show me the Snapchat story from yesterday, which was amazing. But by the time we'd finished watching it, there was no more hot water left.
So I'm up, I'm alive. Chris, in talking to me, has wasted all the hot water in the shower, and all that is coming from that room now is heavy breathing. It's weird. I'm not a man who's ever lacked for words, but I cannot put into words how fucking horrific that shower was. I'm basically Bear Grylls now.
Ugh. I now think we've probably been inducted into, like, the Green Beret or the Navy Seals.
I think we should have been.
Honestly, like, I feel like I've been in Gitmo overnight. I just point out that's an incredibly orange hat.
So, we're going to hit the road.
Yeah.
Jack?
Yeah. We're here in Strasbourg, and we need to make the trip to Basel, which is here, and in a completely different country, even though that's weird because it's on the same map. So, yeah, we're going to head off shortly, and then, yeah, I guess it's the E35.
He's just guessing as well, isn't he?
All the way to Basel, so let's get stuck in. And we are officially underway again. Go on, Kishy P.
Where we go, lads?
No idea.
The best was how the sat-nav hadn't spoke until we went to speakerphone, and then she just wouldn't shut up.
So Aubrey's gone out to pick up some shots, and there's some Liverpool fans over there. I think he's going to try and secretly film them. He's kind of creeping up on them. What? He's getting there. He's right there. There he is. He's gone past them. And now he's in position such that he's technically filming us, but he's also got them in shot. Sneaky. And Tom's just going to go clean the windscreen. No, mate, I haven't got any change. Can you fucking leave us alone?
This is for Basel, baby!
How we actually managed to get this stick with windows that don't open.
So we're here on the board. I've just been told not to video, not to take photos. I'm doing it anyway, because I'm in my bed. We're just waiting to get searched.
Going through checks. Arsehole's intact, which is always a win.
Felt up twice, Paul.
Fuck me.
Was the touch
soft?
He's a gentle lover.
He's a gentle lover. He's the Swiss Border Patrol.
Okay, so here we are, we've arrived in beautiful Basel. The cup final approaches.
There's loads of Sevilla fans. Hola!
Hi.
Loads of Sevilla fans, they're in good spirits because they win this competition all the time. We're going to go, get stuck in, get into the city, go and find some Reds and let it all kick off.
Where are we going?
Remaining
in your room until we are ready for your interrogation.
That way?
Fuck those.
We were following
them and they turned
it out. You're the biggest group! You're supposed to
know where you're going. So we're coming up on the square where Liverpool fans are. You can't hear it now, but there's just this rumble on the horizon. Liverpool songs en masse being sung, can't we?
Liverpool, 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 Liverpool.
Chris, you're buzzing now.
Oh, mate, look at this. Look at this. How can you not be buzzing stood in the middle of this now? Liverpool fans are taking over Basel.
No, it's been great. Everyone's been fantastic and there's plenty of Reds here. We'll see what goes on with the pyro later on. It's always a laugh, isn't it? You know what I mean?
I'm nervous. I was going to say something else, but nah.
He was going to say shit in it.
I didn't know if I had any, if I could get away with that.
Came down yesterday, but yeah, been out all day.
So. How did you get down?
I got the plane. You got the plane today.
Arrived at 6 a.m. this morning. Okay. Zurich. Train from Zurich to Basel.
You've been on it since 6 o'clock this morning.
Exactly, mate. Exactly that.
Yeah, already taken over the square. I've been here for 2 days. I've seen about 40 Sevilla fans.
Liverpool played on the moon. We'd get there. I'm fucking telling you.
Right, okay, we're here. The fun park.
Finally, mate.
Absolutely. What an epic road trip it's been. And we've not even got the game yet. Look, it's kicking up into, as I think you can see, the only place for us to be is square in the middle.
You've
got to
get in there, mate. Go. Hand the mic off.
Ever accused that young man of not giving it the bifters.
Going off me,
unbelievable, Jeff!
Unbelievable!
We don't care what the blue shite say!
No one does, why would we care?
Casey's beer soaked in fucking beer, this is awesome!
I love fucking roll.
And it is. Oh! Hey!
The James Sutton.
So we've been in the square. We've had a good laugh. It's absolutely lashing down with rain. And now we're going to make the walk up to St. Jacob Park.
Cannot
for the match.
Let's do it, man.
So it's been soaking. I think the rain stopped for a bit, but you know what? Who cares? Not dampening my mood in any way, shape, or form.
Check now. Always a good thing. Going through this tunnel, I imagine there's going to be lots of singing going down.
On the Master Stadium.
Here we are, mate.
That's the stadium behind us.
This is it, the Basel road trip, at least now, is at an end. Oh, there's just a little matter of the Europa League final.
Oh my word, the nerves have kicked in big time now. Look at the fans around us, yeah. Everywhere, mate.
The walk's been amazing, the day's been incredible, to now. And now, we've done our part to this point. We're gonna get in there, continue to do our part, and then the players are going to take the stage. Can't wait. Good luck. Not really.
Have a good one.
Cheers, lads. Enjoy the game. Just not very much, hopefully.
So, we're in. We're in through the checkpoint. Checkpoint Alpha or Gamma or whatever. Checkpoint Charlie. That was stupid, the amount of people and the amount of gates, and there was one person with a pen checking stuff, so, but never mind, we're in, mate.
We are in.
Now, we've just found a very familiar face over here in Basel.
Turns out, baby, that's right, where we are.
Right, okay. Because he's still the man behind the exceptional Redmen TV show.
Amongst other things, like.
Alcohol free beer. You said there's a Mickey Mouse fucking cup anyway. Fuck off, best sleep ever, that lad.
We did it. We are in.
Oh! with hope in your heart, and you'll never walk alone. You'll never walk alone.
Good time, Sevilla 3-1. Threw it away ultimately, you know. You're in the driver's seat, you're 1-0 up, and you let yourselves get beaten. Not all the players in the world, Sevilla, their fans are outstanding, exceptional. But, you know, when you're in the lead, you're in the box seat, you can't afford to throw it away. It's as simple as that.
Well, the Redmen TV, Liverpool have just lost the Europa League final 3-1 to Sevilla at St Jakob's Park.
Liverpool have been beaten in the St Jakob Park 3-1 by Sevilla on a night that, for me, I just always thought we were going to win that game.
The day built up fantastically, it all felt like it was leading to something.
Place is just dejected, isn't it, at the end of the day?
Did nothing in that second half. Nothing in the second half of note. Right now, everyone's got a right to be completely downbeat and dejected about that, is all I'll say. I'm going to keep smiling because I'm a glass half full kind of guy. I've loved the experience, I've loved the journey, I've had a magnificent day, and it's been let down by the lads on the pitch ultimately, and it's not the first time, won't be the last time, but you know what, I've had some terrific memories in this competition. I will carry those with me going forward.
It's going to be an incredibly difficult drive home, but where are we as a football club right now? We're still in a better position than we were at the end of last season.
It wasn't meant to be. Ultimately, I'll look back at this whole thing, hopefully, and remember the good times, because we've had some great times getting here, we've met some great people, we've seen some amazing scenes in that park today, just that I don't think I'll ever top as a Liverpool fan.
Yeah, I think we will.
When we were driving down, I think I said something on the lines of, if Liverpool don't win this trophy, then the season could be classed as a failure. And look, any season where you lose two cup finals, you definitely can't consider it a success. But even with the gift of hindsight of just a day, it feels like there was more at stake for this match, more than I ever dreamed was possible when we set off 900 miles earlier. And somehow, it wasn't just about a game of football. It was about, and it sounds a bit prosaic, but almost the soul of Liverpool Football Club, the renewal of that soul was at stake here. And in that regards, I think Liverpool were absolutely phenomenal. You had guys in the 60s alongside kids in single digits dancing and singing and partying together under the same cause. It felt like a rebirth in some regards when, you know, Kenny Dalglish lost the FA Cup final. That felt like an end. When Brendan Rodgers came toward the end of his tenure, we lost to Stoke, we started the next season, it wasn't quite right. That felt like an end. Under Jurgen Klopp and this final here, it's the end of a season, but it's not the end. If anything, it's only the beginning. And that's just, for me, that's just incredible. And I genuinely can't wait to see what the next season's hold. Could be next level greatness.
Sun,
Chris.